Safe Berks on BCTV is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.
Hi, and thank you for tuning in to Safe Berks on BCTV. My name is Francine Scoboria, and I serve as the communications coordinator at Safe Berks. I want to start by thanking the sponsor of our show, Visions Federal Credit Union. Thank you for your support. Safe Berks is the local nonprofit that provides free services to survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault. Our services are free, they're confidential, and they're available 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Our services are available in all languages. Safe Berks was founded in 1976 as Berks Women in Crisis and was also known as BWIC. In 2016, we changed our name to Safe Berks to make sure that it is very clear that we serve all survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault. Our services include shelter, our 24-hour hotline and text line, counseling, legal services, community outreach and response, medical advocacy, and education. Our 24-hour free hotline is 844-789-SAFE, which is 7233, or anyone who needs help can also text the words Safe Berks to 20121. We are here to help. Today, we are going to focus on the Safe Berks Counseling Department. I am honored to interview my colleague and my friend, Dashmire Charles, who serves as a counselor at Safe Berks. Dashmire, I want to thank you for taking the time to join this show. I know you are very busy. And also, I want to take time to just say thank you for everything you do for Safe Berks and for survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault.
Thank you, Francine, and thank you, BCTV, for having us here today.
Great. So I am very happy to be focusing on the counseling department because our counseling department, it's a big, important part of what we offer to survivors. So I'll kind of dive in here to the first question. Dashmire, we are thrilled that you joined the Safe Berks team about 1 year ago. And can you share with our viewers some information about yourself and why you made the decision to work at Safe Berks?
Yes, I will. Thank you, everyone, for having me here today. My name is Dashmire, and I joined Safe Berks in April of 2022. And the reason why I joined Safe Berks is because I share the same values as Safe Berks, which is respect, education, hope, and safety and empowerment. And I am really lucky to be part of Safe Berks organization.
Oh, thank you so much. And I know I speak for everyone at Safe Berks when we say we are lucky that you are at Safe
Berks.
Thank
you. I appreciate
you bring
that.
So much kindness and compassion to everything you do and also positive energy.
Thank you. You too.
Oh, thank you. Well, it's one of the pleasures of working at Safe Berks is the people that I have gotten to meet and work with. So yes, that's kind of the added bonus. I'll just put that out there in case anyone is looking to join the Safe Berks team, because I know we do have a few open positions, because you get to work with a really amazing group of people.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. So I'll ask the next question is, can you share some information about the counseling services that you provide to survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault?
Yes. So I provide individual empowerment counseling to victims of domestic violence and sexual abuse. It could be children, adults, and what we do is we support each one of our victims and survivor through their healing process, and we provide support, safety, and we help them achieve their goals through this journey.
Yes, that is wonderful. And why do you think that these free and confidential counseling services that you and the other counselors provide, why are they so important for survivors?
It's not only is it confidential, it's really important because we are here to help them through their trauma-informed counseling services. Yeah. We help them by providing a safe haven for individuals of domestic violence and sexual abuse, express themselves, And listen, we're here to listen. You know, sometimes the victims just need somebody to listen to, and that's what we're here. We're here to encourage them, uplift them, and help them feel empowered again.
That's wonderful. And I think you make a great point about the listening, because we know that for really thousands of years, there's been a stigma that people who have been abused through domestic violence or sexual assault sometimes feel this stigma, and they feel like they can't talk to other people about it, and they might keep it inside. And that can be very dangerous to them emotionally. And they really could benefit from having someone who is an expert in this field just listen to them with kindness. So it's really important that people know that.
And that goes a long way, just listening.
Yes, that is wonderful. And I'm going to now share some information with our viewers about our financial empowerment program. The Safe Berks Financial Empowerment Program is offered through the counseling department. And it includes the following free services: individual counseling focusing on economic and housing goals, financial empowerment classes, job fairs, assistance with resume writing, assistance with clothing for interviews for employment, connections with employers who are seeking staff, connections with housing opportunities, and assistance in recovery from financial abuse. Our financial empowerment program is very important because many survivors of domestic violence have experienced financial abuse. This is a common form of control used by abusers. Financial abuse can include preventing the victim from working, preventing access to financial resources, and even destroying the victim's credit on purpose. Safe Berks provides assistance to survivors to help them recover from financial abuse and build financial stability and success, such an important part of an independent life. To request financial empowerment counseling or for more information, you can email Michelle N at safeberks.org, and that's spelled M-I-C-H-E-L-L-E-N at safeberks.org, or call 610-373-1206, extension 208. And some people don't realize that this financial abuse is a form of domestic violence, and it is something Safe Berks is here to provide help with. So if that is something you or someone you love is suffering from, we hope that you will reach out and explore these free services. So now I'll ask Dashmire the next question. What types of support groups does the Safe Berks Counseling Department offer?
I'm going to go through the list.
Yes,
and
wonderful.
And then I'll go into details about the group that I am running at the moment. So we provide a women's and men's domestic violence support group.
Great.
We provide a women's support group for women ages 18 and older who experience domestic violence and sexual assault. We also provide a Spanish-speaking group here at Safe Berks.
Wonderful.
And also residential support group. So the group I am currently running is a woman and men's domestic violence support group. It is an open group, so meaning that clients are always welcome to join in.
Good.
And it is a safe place for individuals who experience domestic violence and sexual abuse to come in, express themselves, share their stories, and receive support and feedback from the members here at the support group.
That is wonderful. And I know I've actually heard from some survivors who went through some of the groups, and they have said that it made such a difference in their life and really helped them on their journey of healing. Because like you said, to be with other people who have these same experiences is really powerful.
It really is, and you're able to receive feedback and develop coping skills and feel empowered that you're not the only one.
That's wonderful. That's just great. And we've talked about this a little bit, but is there any other things you want to add about why the support groups are so helpful? I know you talk a lot about self-care, and that's probably one of the things that comes up.
So I promote self-care, positivity, and all of my individual counseling, because it is very important that you take care of everyone, not just clients. I myself need to take care of myself just so I can present myself better for the people that I am working with and my victims of yes. domestic violence and sexual abuse. And in our support group, it is member run, so members are running the group. So it gives them yeah. like a space where they can be themselves and yeah. kind of run their group the way that they would yeah. like and yes. feel comfortable with.
Yes, and I'm sure that's very empowering to them too, mm-hmm. that they are running the group, exactly. they are the people benefiting, and they're the leaders also. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I agree with you 100%. Myself personally, I try to, as much as possible, make time for self-care, because it's not something I realized in my younger years as much, mm-hmm. but it's good for people to realize it as soon as possible that you really do need to take care of yeah. yourself. You can't really help other people if you're not exactly. first taking care of yourself. So for our clients, it's very important, for our staff, and it's important for everybody.
Yeah.
So I know for me, I like to write in my journal. I like to paint. Those are some of the things that, you know, I like to do for self-care. Mm-hmm. But it could be anything.
Yeah.
That exercise mm-hmm. and yoga and...
Yeah, I agree. And then while working with clients too, you're learning new self-care too for yourself.
Right. So even through work mm-hmm. and through these groups, you actually can learn yourself too.
Yeah.
So we're all learning from each mm-hmm. other. It's just great. Okay, then I wanted to, I wanted to ask you about this, and I think this is so wonderful, that you are bilingual in English and Haitian Creole.
Yeah.
Great. Did you grow up speaking two languages?
Yes. So I grew up in Haiti. So my first language is Haitian Creole, and then I learned English.
That's
and
wonderful.
I was very honored to provide counseling services to a Haitian client.
Yes, that is wonderful. And at Safe Berks, we provide our services in all languages, but it's so wonderful mm-hmm. that you can specifically offer someone who speaks Haitian Creole services in their native language directly.
Yeah.
And that's just wonderful.
Thank you.
So we're getting already toward the end of our show. It's just flying by mm-hmm. because it's so interesting to learn about more about our counseling department. But before we get to the end of the show, I wanted to check, Dashmire, if there's anything you'd like to add, and also, if you could let people know how to reach you or the counseling department.
Okay, so you can reach the counseling department at 610-373-1206. Our extension is 606. Or right. you can reach me at my email, which is Dashmire, DashmireC, at safeberks.org.
Wonderful.
And the only thing I would like to share yes. to close our session, our meeting for today, is that whether you are someone who is watching this and you are a survivor or a victim of domestic violence or sexual assault, I just want to say that you are not alone, and that Safe Berks is here for you whenever you're ready. Or if you know a family member or friend who needs support, please have them reach out to us. Again, it is a safe place. We are here to help everyone.
Yes, thank you so much. That is exactly the heart and soul of Safe Berks.
Yeah.
Is we're here to help 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. No one should ever be abused or threatened ever. Safety is the most basic human right. And without safety, it's difficult to advance in all the other areas of life.
Mm-hmm.
You really need to have safety
yeah.
as a baseline. So if you are not experiencing safety in your life, you deserve to be safe.
Mm-hmm.
And there are people who can help you with the tools needed to develop a safe, happy, independent life. And that is exactly what each person
yeah.
deserves and should have. So as our show is coming to a close, I wanted to, first of all, thank Dashmire for being here and for everything you do.
And thank you. Yes. You too. Yeah. Your department served a big purpose here at Safe Berks as well, too.
Oh, thank you so
You're
much.
Welcome.
It's my pleasure. And I did want to share some information with our viewers about our volunteer cooking program. We have a wonderful volunteer cooking program, and we are always seeking more volunteers to help us with this program. So if you're someone who likes to cook or want to get involved, we look for volunteers to cook and deliver dinner to our residents 365 days a year. Mm-hmm. Another option, if you're not someone who really likes to cook but you would like to help, is we're always very happy to have people sponsor a dinner for our residents from a local restaurant, and we can help coordinate that if you would like to do that. For more information or to schedule a dinner, please contact Mindy McIntosh, who is our Director of Development. This program is her baby, and she's been working on this for over 5 years, and she does a great job. And it's a lot of fun, too. A lot of people have a lot of fun with it. You can reach Mindy at 610-468-9637 or by email at mindym@safeberks.org. Our volunteer cooks include individuals, families, work groups, church groups, Girl Scout troops, and many others. And sharing a homemade meal with the residents of Safe Berks, it provides them with both the physical nutrition that they need, but also with the kindness that they know that someone cares about them in the community. And it is so important for their healing journey to experience both the nutrition and the kindness. And also, people have a lot of fun by bringing in their own family recipes. Like, people might bring pasta dishes, chicken dishes, taco night. Mm-hmm. They might do shepherd's pie. I could go on and on. It's mm-hmm. every meal that you can imagine. Anything that you and your family enjoy, I'm sure our residents mm-hmm. would enjoy. And Mindy will work with you to make sure that we make sure there's never the same meal two nights in a row. So she does a great job with spreading that out. We also have pizza nights and other kinds of fun nights. So if you're interested in helping, please reach out to mindym@safeberks.org. And we also want to say thank you to all our volunteer cooks, because you do a huge service to help Safe Berks clients in their healing journey. And one other way, if you would like to help Safe Berks, is to donate new items that we need, such as pillows, towels, washcloths, sheets for twin size beds, toiletries, clothing, as well as items needed by babies and toddlers. We often have many babies and toddlers who are so beautiful and have all the needs that babies and toddlers have, which is diapers, baby wipes, diaper cream, pacifiers, baby bottles, and sippy cups. Those things are always really appreciated. For more information about donating new items to Safe Berks, you can check out our website, which is at www.safeberks.org. You would click on Donate and then look for Donate Goods and In-Kind Services. We always post our wish list. Or you can contact Heather Fink, who is the Donor and Board Relations Administrator. She's at 610-373-1206, extension 115, or heatherf@safeberks.org. And as we close our show, we want to thank you, our viewers, for tuning in to Safe Berks on BCTV. We also want to thank all our donors, volunteers, advocates, and friends in the community for everything you do to help and support Safe Berks. There is no way that we could provide these free services 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, without the very generous support of the Berks County community. And we want you to know we are extremely grateful for that support. So thank you. And for anyone who might be dealing with domestic violence or sexual assault, we want to remind you that our 24-hour free hotline is 844-789-SAFE, or you can text the words Safe Berks to 20121. Our services are free and confidential. So you can find more information about Safe Berks on our website or by following us on social media, including Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and LinkedIn. Thank you for your time. Together, we can build a Safe Berks.
Safe Berks on BCTV is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.